What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes and Derek, the Young HVAC GOAT. We got this new residential client here in Howard Beach, Queens. He's got a brand new US boiler, Burnham Alta tankless combi, the ALTAC 200 model, and it's got an error code. No bueno, and the thing is like 2 months old. Let's go get him up and running.
SCA10, we're waiting for the error code to appear, but in the meantime, grandma got ran over by a reindeer, walking home from our house Christmas Eve. You can say there's no such thing as Santa, but as for me and grandpa, we believe. Okay, let's turn up the heat. And there is the error message, H05. And I'm going to show you how to troubleshoot, diagnose, and repair. So this H05 means low water flow. It's not sensing water. So we're going to just pop that open and take a look on the interior components. Here's our internal circulator. It's a Grundfos UPS 15-78. We're going to make sure that this is getting power. So you can just remove the Molex connector, and you saw the little flash right there. So we're going to test this with a voltmeter between the black and the white terminals to make sure we have 110 volts. You're going to like zap yourself. And we have 123 volts. Okay, very good. So we have good voltage there. So let's turn off power. Excellent. And if we remove this screw here, we should be able to freely spin around the end of the shaft of the impeller. Okay, a little bit of water coming out of there is expected. And let's see if we can freely spin that. And she's jammed up. She don't want to spin. She's not spinning, so no bueno. We have a bad circ. I'm going to release some pressure from the boiler by opening up the bleeder hose valve into a bucket. Now, unfortunately, this installer did not install any flush valves anywhere here, not on the tankless domestic cold water and hot water outlet, which is also missing. We're also missing a temperature and pressure safety valve on the domestic hot water. That's missing as well. So, not too bright of the installer here. There's no way to ever service this system unless you cut in tankless flush valves here. All right, now we're going to use an Allen key and remove those bolts, four of them, on the front of the circuit. And you know, since it's European standard, Allen keys aren't working. Am I gonna be able to get this in there? Come on, baby. All right, one more. Hold that for a second. What happens when you don't install valves? You get water everywhere. It's funny. This spins freely. Wonder if it was jammed up in anything here. Any gaskets or washers in this thing? Oh, it's already one on there. What else they give us? What's in there? Let me see these. They give you new ones?
Yeah.
Flow restrictor. Those new ones. Four of them?
Yeah.
See the hole. All right, let's
cut our tip off. Oh, yeah.
Plug our power back in. Put that speed in the middle. I'm gonna get the leaf blower and blow out this water. Now we got a lot of water underneath the high voltage control, low voltage control. A lot of standing water in there, but most importantly, the gasket on the circulator is intact. Biggest observation though, this machine can never be serviced because it lacks any valves. And important temperature and pressure safety valve on the domestic water line.
Could it be downstairs?
Nope. Draining out the air, purging out the air from top of the heat exchanger. That's good. All right, put right on. All right, now we wait.